Hello, YouTube. It is Dion again. I am on chapter 4 of my book to YouTube about growing up as a Jehovah's Witness. If you go through 1, 2, and 3, you'll see a lot about the Jehovah's Witnesses and what I went through as a child. Now, the reason why I'm coming up here now, I do want to definitely continue the YouTube and so forth and do my chapters and so forth, my open book. But I'm coming up here right now because I am having witnesses that aren't supposed to be up there. I mean, that's what I'm thinking, because if you're being a part of the world by, you know, indulging in online things and information like that, you know, I'm like really literally being attacked and so forth. I'm trying to figure this out because I don't understand the reason why you would be up here attacking anyone anyway. Now, my comment tonight was that someone was saying something about, now they attacked me from someone else's YouTube too, that's the thing about it, but they were saying something about unconditional love, and I was feeling like, because my dad literally told me that if I had a child, my child wasn't doing what I wanted to do, wouldn't that upset me? Of course it would upset me, but guess what, being I have unconditional love, I'm still going to love my child regardless. It does not matter to me, I'm going to love my child. So, there's no such thing as an unconditional love that shuns someone. So, this young lady was basically saying, well, if you're committing fornication, you're committing adultery, if you're doing things that are not right in the eyes of Jehovah, then you, therefore, you're not able to be loved by your parents. You shouldn't expect that. So, me personally, I told her back that, you know, you can be happy with the religion that you're in. There is nothing wrong with that. I would not be knocking anyone's religion. If that's what you believe, that's what you believe. But you have to understand, you must respect other people and their beliefs and their opinions, because guess what? Everyone has one. Okay, you can't, and everybody's born with free will. So you can't just assume, just because that's the way you feel they should believe, that you're right. Because it's not even fair for you to even think that way. To me, that seems like you're busy judging someone. Okay? And the last I found or heard, that we shouldn't be judging each other, which I see a lot of judging going on with Jehovah's Witnesses. Basically, if you're not doing what Jehovah wants you to do, or in your opinions and so forth, then you're just wrong. So I just wanted to put the question out there to any other Jehovah's Witnesses that are you know, up on YouTube and checking out the videos that you do see, because I see a lot of other people that are, that were Jehovah's Witnesses or grew up, and I see on their pages they're being attacked as well. So I just want to ask you, Jehovah's Witnesses that are coming to these pages, let me ask you, does this mean that everyone, and there are millions and millions of people in the world, does this mean that everyone that does not serve Jehovah or is not in Jehovah's Witnesses organization, that we will perish or we will die? Is this what this means, just because we're not in the same organization as you are? Because you do have people that honestly really do have a genuine love for God. They may not be Jehovah's Witnesses, but they have a great heart. They love other people. They go out and they talk about God, and they preach about their religion and so forth. So you're trying to tell me that someone that's a Jehovah's Witness and he's busy molesting a child, or he's busy committing murder, or he's busy doing God knows what, okay? But he hasn't confessed it to you though, okay? But he's a Jehovah's Witness, versus somebody that it's doing exactly what they're supposed to be doing. Just morally, they're doing what they're supposed to be doing. And they really don't have anything to hide. They really genuinely have a great heart. They love God. They love the Lord. However you want to say, they love Jehovah. They literally, this is what they do. They live for it. They missionary everything. So you're trying to tell me that because this Jehovah's Witness over here just committing every other crime in the world, and I've seen it done, okay, I know of witnesses that have killed, I know of witnesses that have stealed, I know of witnesses that have lied, cheat, all of that, okay? So you're trying to tell me that because this person over here that has this beautiful heart is not a Jehovah's Witness, they're gonna perish, they're gonna die? Funny thing today, I was talking to my daughter, and she was like, we were actually talking about the witnesses for some reason. We got on the conversation, and I don't badmouth witnesses, so don't think that. But we, because I don't, like I've said in my past videos, it's the way I was brought up. I don't knock any religions and so forth, but the way I was brought up, I, you know, don't agree with it. Anyway, so we were sitting up there talking. My daughter's 18 now, so she's like, wow, she was like, Mom, what would it have been like if we, if I had been a Jehovah's Witness, if we had grew up like that? She was like, I don't think I would have been able to deal with it. I was like, well, basically, like I grew up like I was on punishment from everything. You know, I couldn't do this, I couldn't do this, I mean, it's always something that you cannot do. Okay, so I told my daughter, I was like, it would simply be where I would tell you, okay, we're getting ready to go out in field service. We're going to have a book study. We're getting ready to sit down and have a study. We're going to work on those return visits. We're going to go to the theocratic ministry school. We're going to work on a talk. And then we're going to do the same thing again, over and over again. And how dare you think about getting an education, because what I need you to do is get a trade. Because in Armageddon, you're going to be running. Okay? You don't need to be thinking about anything that has to do with being successful. The only thing you need to concentrate on is going to the Kingdom Hall, making sure you get these return visits, making sure that you have a study, making sure that you get more studies, and making sure that anything that has to do with the organization is done. Anything else past that, it's obsolete. Really, you don't need to worry about that. So this is basically, my daughter was like, wow, there's no way. Another thing I want to think about, talk to you guys about really fast too. Mother's Day just passed. Okay. We never, ever celebrated Mother's Day when we were growing up. We didn't celebrate Father's Day. We didn't celebrate birthdays, Christmas, anything. We didn't celebrate it. So, you know, people start getting older and everything. People notice that their mom, their children are calling them up and everything. And, you know, feeling weird about it. So my mom basically, it's kind of like calling and them stuff. I'm like, I didn't call her on Mother's Day, because it's like, why pretend? We've never celebrated Mother's Day, so why should we start pretending now? So I didn't call her, and I know she probably, for whatever reason, I don't know why, but she must be feeling bad or something, because she probably wanted to hear from our children and so forth on Mother's Day, just like the rest of her sisters and brothers did. You have to realize, what I've thought about a lot of times is a lot of reasons why we may not have been able to celebrate these holidays and so forth. It may have been because maybe your mom is not a Jehovah's Witness, or maybe the kids aren't Jehovah's Witnesses. So why celebrate this with someone that's not a part of Jehovah's organization? So to cut this all out, we're just, whoever's not within this organization, you don't get to celebrate anything, because you might not have a mom that's a Jehovah's Witness. You may not have a kid that's a witness. So we'll just cut out all the celebrations of anything. But we will definitely celebrate death. Don't forget that. We're going to definitely celebrate death. I know I said this in another video, but I just really don't understand that. I really did feel bad that I couldn't, like, call my mom up and be like, you know, Happy Mom's Day, or, you know, I don't even know how to say it. Happy Mother's Day. I've never been able to call her or say Merry Christmas. You know, things like that, of that nature. Family things. Because a lot of those, you know, even if it, whether it's a religion or rather, not even religion, whether it's a holiday or whatever, it is a lot about family. And when you have a family that's just like shunning, and you have friends that were basically in an organization and they're shunning because they're all Jehovah's Witnesses, you have to actually sit there and think, like, I mean, what kind of God would actually shun you away from your parents, or shun the kids away from their parents? Who would do that? Who would birth someone into the world and not have anything to do with them based on what they believe? Now, I have never killed anyone in my life. Never did anything that, you know, I've been pretty good. Riding pretty straight. I'm not perfect, definitely. But when it's all said and done, I'm not locked up. I'm not in prison anywhere. I raised my daughter. My daughter's 18. She's about to graduate next month. I've done a damn good job, if I may say so myself, without any parents around to be of any support or whatever. I've done a damn good job. I'm like, why can't I at least have, you know, good parents around? But, you know, I can't do this because of the simple fact that we're the Jehovah's Witnesses, you know. Parents are Jehovah's Witnesses. We don't get to associate. I'm hoping they'll be able to come to the graduation, because at least that'll be something, some type of way of us being able to get some type of celebration in, some type of family time in or whatever, because my daughter is graduating. But I just wanted to just put that out there, you know. This has nothing to do with my chapters. I'll go into that some more once I put some more information together and so forth. But I just people, just the witnesses that are up here, just think about it. I mean, think logically. What type of God, or loving God, as you guys say, is going to want you to shun people that you love? If there's something that's going on in someone's life, say they're committing adultery, say they're committing fornication, say they're doing any of these things that you're getting disfellowship or shunning for, should you be, at that point in that person's life, there for that person instead of shunning them? You know? I don't hear anything from my dad asking me anything about, like, my dad's an elder. I think I said that before my other videos. That's 1, 2, and 3. But my dad's an elder. I don't hear anything. I can't get a phone call from him and it's like, hello, how are you doing? It's hello in a scripture. Hello, and why aren't you doing this? Hello, and if you pray, then you won't be this. And, I mean, come on, can we get some real fatherly love? I mean, at least, I mean, my mom does ask me how I'm doing and so forth, at least. I mean, I can get that much, but people just because you believe one way, that's cool. Nobody's knocking your beliefs at all. I'm not knocking them. I've never knocked anything anybody believes. I mean, whatever you believe, that's you. But when it comes down to it, we're all born with free will. You cannot make someone think or feel or act like you want them to just because that's the way you want them to. I was looking at a video the other day. They were canceling a young lady on the characters in her book of fiction. There are characters, fictional characters in a book. The elders were at her house for this. I mean, it's a waste of time to be sitting around being that nosy to me. I really think so. I mean, anyway, I don't know. I just getting attacked by the witnesses up here. I just don't understand why you guys on. It's no disrespect, but just try not to be disrespectful. I don't have any disrespect for you. I mean, if other people are up here reading and they want to know, guess what? They're on the internet. The internet is a web full of information. There's nothing wrong with seeking out information unless you're within the organization. And if you're in the organization, you're not supposed to be on YouTube. So that means that you're breaking rules right there. So you probably should stop passing judgment, get off of YouTube, and go grab yourself a Bible study. You know? Go do a return visit. And I'm not mocking you or nothing, but that's what you're supposed to be doing. Stay off of YouTube. You're being disrespectful. It's not for you. And then you got your people also that were up here years ago. You were disfellowship, and you say you weren't bashing witnesses, but I looked at your videos and you're bashing the witnesses whenever it was that you put this YouTube. Now that you're back within the organization, now you're feeling like, I mean, you're extra sanctified and so forth. And you can just come out and come at people like you're doing. But, you know, it is what it is. And I just want to say that please stay in tune with the videos with the Growing Up as a Jehovah's Witness. And I'm going to get back at you. All right?